University of Michigan paleontologist Philip Gingrich and co-workers recently announced the discovery of fossils that shed light on whale evolution. Since their discovery in Pakistan, Gingrich has been studying the fossils.
So we've found two specimens of a new kind of archaic whale that lived 47 million years ago. And one is a female and one is a male. When this whale was found, all it was showing was the chalk line on the surface of the earth. And the bones all made sense until I got into this part of the specimen, and it was full of little teeth. And I was excited because I thought, oh boy, we've finally gotten the skeleton of the small whale that I think is in these beds. And as I kept working and cleaning, suddenly nothing made sense because the ribs are all going the wrong direction. The vertebrae are too big for the small skull and small teeth. Nothing made sense, nothing made sense, nothing made sense until I got all the way to the front and uncovered the mother's skull. And suddenly I realized the reason these teeth were small is they're deciduous teeth of a baby that's still in the womb. And we've never seen anything like that in early whale evolution. So I've been excited about this ever since.
In addition to the female, Gingrich's team also found a nearly complete male skeleton at the same site.
Here's the male skeleton of Maiacetus. It's exciting because it's the first time we can document sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism is the difference between males and females. Here you can see the canine teeth, and the male teeth are conspicuously larger than the canine teeth in the female. It helps us understand how to associate the males and females of the same species, but it also tells us that the dimorphism at this stage of whale evolution wasn't great. Today, whales are all over the spectrum, so we know it doesn't have any great meaning in terms of maintaining harems or anything like that. This helps us understand much better the development of early whales, the transition that whales made from life on land to life in the sea. The foot is here, modified as a flipper, but it's not nearly as big as it is in the contemporary whale Rhodocetus, which has a much larger foot compared to Maiacetus. The other thing that's important about this whale is rat-like tail at the very end, but no trace of a fluke. And at this stage of whale evolution, that still hasn't appeared. The most exciting is that the head is facing back toward the mother's pelvis, and this baby is going to be born head first. Whales today are born tail first because they're born in the sea. Now we know why they still spent time on land, and that's where they bred and gave birth. And that's an indication that they hadn't yet made the transition to life in the sea.